Welcome to service number 5 of the Ministry of Writing, Falling Leaves. If you don't already have the writing audio playing in the background, please do that now. And if you need to re-download it, you can get it at tombird.com/audio. Just a couple of things before we get started. First, how to use the Zoom chat. So if you have any questions throughout the evening, I ask that you send a message to me, Janelle, and you do that by using the chat feature on Zoom. So from the meeting controls, you'll click the chat icon, which is a little message bubble. It opens the chat on the right that looks something like the image on your screen here. That's where you can chat, type in your message in the chat box, and then select my name to send that message to me. You'll also see Tom's name there, but he's usually pretty focused on the writing exercises and meditating and not monitoring the chat. So we ask that you send all messages to me unless otherwise specified. And if I send a message to you or the group and you don't have that chat box open, that chat icon in your toolbar is going to flash orange at you to let you know that there's a new message to read. And you'll just click that to open it up and read the message and respond if and as needed. All right, and then for the next few minutes, we are going to prepare into the DAW state, or the divine author within state. First up, the confirmation. This session was specifically designed by author and mentor Tom Bird to lead you through the art of divinely led writing into a potential direct communion with the loving God Almighty. To receive from this session as much as possible, it is suggested that you surrender to the following exercise cues and adhere to the following writing rules, which I will read very, very slowly right now. Writing rules. Number one, keep writing. Each exercise is timed and we will announce when it's time to stop that exercise. So until then, keep writing. They will also be displayed with the start and stop times on your screen. So if you're not sure where we are, maybe you got too into the zone and aren't sure you heard, you can always look up at the screen for reference to see where we are. Number two, go wherever the writing takes you. And the point of this is to let God and Spirit speak to you and tell you how to answer these questions. So just let that flow through instead of trying to actually answer them yourself. Write as fast as you can. And these are timed sessions. Sometimes you won't feel like you have enough time, or you're going to be very, very surprised at how many words, what all you can get out in the time that we allow, as long as you just write as fast as you can. Number four, don't read what you wrote until after the service. On occasion, we do have exercises that ask you to refer back to a previous exercise, but generally speaking, don't read what you wrote until after the service. You can go back over it, see where it took you later, but don't read what you wrote until later, because that also hinders your ability to write as fast as you can. Keep the writing audio playing at all times, as we mentioned. It's really helpful to keep you in that divine author within space. People love that if you're new to it. People find it super helpful and play it for themselves all the time. So keep that going. And then always write what you feel. It ties everything together. Just let Spirit, let God speak to you, and you'll get the clarity and the answers, whatever it is that you are looking for, so long as you write what you feel. And finally, I'm going to read the author's prayer. This is a prayer that Tom wrote. I will be reading it 3 times. Encourage you to read aloud with me, bow your head, close your eyes, whatever it is that makes you feel most comfortable. That's fine with us. I come to you in the most humblest of all manners. Thank you, God, for leading me to surrender to your goodness, love, healing, guidance, and protection as I experience your inspiration pouring through me. And thank you for leading me to surrender any fears, doubts, worries, and concerns that have stood in the way of me experiencing the oneness we share. In your name I pray. Amen. I come to you in the most humblest of all manners. Thank you, God, for leading me to surrender to your goodness, love, healing, guidance, and protection as I experience your inspiration pouring through me. And thank you for leading me to surrender any fears, doubts, worries, and concerns that have stood in the way of me experiencing the oneness we share. In your name I pray. Amen. I come to you in the most humblest of all manners. Thank you, God, for leading me to surrender to your goodness, love, healing, guidance, and protection as I experience your inspiration pouring through me. And thank you for leading me to surrender any fears, doubts, worries, and concerns that have stood in the way of me experiencing the oneness we share. In your name I pray. Amen.
Thank you, Janelle. Close your eyes, please. Bow your heads. Take a nice deep breath in through your nose and blow it out through your mouth. That's it. Nice deep breath in. Blow it out. Again. Again. Twice more. Once more. With your eyes closed, meet God in your mind. He, she's waiting for you to show up this evening. God's been waiting for you. Take a deep breath in. Blow it out. Nice deep breath in. Blow it out. Twice more. Nice deep breath in. Blow it out. Nice deep breath in. Blow it out. And ask God this question. What do you have to say to me tonight, God? What do you have to say to me tonight, God? What do I need to hear? Listen with your heart. And open your eyes. Write the response. And write. What do you need to hear tonight? Let God speak to you through your writing. And breathe and smile and listen and write. Listen to God. Sit up straight. There you go. Look good, Nancy. Let God speak through your writing tonight. To your soul, to your mind, to your heart, to your ears, to your feelings, to you, to you. Keep listening, keep writing. Keep listening, keep writing. That's it. Smelling's okay. What does God want you to hear tonight? Thank God for what is being said. Thank God for what is being said and what is being shared with you. Thank God. Thank you, God, for blank. Thank you, God, for blank. Thank you, God, for blank. Next, Janelle. Exercise number one. Ooh, not on topic. How seasonal. Number two, Janelle. Ooh, getting down and personal now. Let them fall. Let them fall. Let them drop. Number three, Janelle, number three. Ooh. Stay with it. Stay with it. Number four. Ooh, where's a good one? Number five. Cool. Next, please. It's been a long, short night. You've done very well. Done very well. We'll take a moment to thank God for being here tonight. Thank yourself for being here tonight as well, too. Give yourself a big hug. Big hug. Say I love you. You're the greatest. You're brave, you're ingenious, you're brilliant, you're loving, you're safe, you're protected, you're God's child. Then close your eyes one more time. See God in your mind. And what does God have to say to you now? What does God have to say to you now? Write it down. And write it down. Thank God as you're writing this down. Be in gratitude. Be in gratitude. Thank you all for being here tonight. Janelle, God blesses you. God blesses you.
Thanks, everyone. We will be sending out the replay tomorrow morning or sometime tomorrow. And be on lookout for next month's announcement via email. And you can always find that at tombird.com. And we always just like to mention that, you know, these are free webinars, but if you feel like you'd like to offer a donation, we are gladly accepting those, but of course not mandatory, not expected. And if you'd like to do that, you can visit us at tombird.com/donate and donate in any dollar amount that you like. Thanks so much for being here, and we hope to see you next month. Have a great rest of your evening or morning or afternoon, wherever you are. Thank you. Bye.